In this video, you'll learn how to work with charts and sparklines inside of reports. I've already created a master detail report based on the Northwind database. I use the categories table as the master area of the report and the products as the detail. You can see how that's set up here. If I go to the Report Explorer, you'll see in the detail section each of the categories, and then in the detail report, I have each of the products. You can also see that via the field list. Let's take a look at the report. We want to look at a chart that compares each item in stock versus on order numbers. First, let me explain how data is set up inside the report. In this detail section, we have a series of repeating category items. In this section, we have a series of repeated product items that belong to each category. But we have this header that represents all of them for each particular category. Since that's the case, we're going to drop the chart directly into the group header. First, let's make this a little bigger. Take these items and move them down. Next, from the toolbox, drag a chart directly onto the design surface. And immediately, you'll see the chart wizard appear. We'll choose the bar chart, leave the appearance at default, remove the series that have already been added, and add one ourselves. This one will be the In Stock series. Notice to bind the data properly, if you go over to the data section in series binding, you'll see that we're automatically bound to the right thing. Now we're trying to bind to the series of products that belong to each category. In order to do that, we go to the argument section. We scroll up and we go to the category products data section. Then we choose the product name as the argument. Next, as the value, we're going to choose the units in stock. We'll go ahead and hit finish and resize this so it fits a little bit better. Now notice when you hit preview, you can see all the items in stock for this category, namely beverages. Let's do some in-house cleaning to make this chart better, and let's add the On Order series. Click on the Smart Tag and select Run Wizard. And go back to Series. We'll add another one and call it On Order. Next, we'll go to the Data section, and in the Series Binding, we'll go back to the On Order series and we'll bind it appropriately again. Notice we're binding to the Categories Products section. So we'll select Product Name, and then we'll go to Value, and we'll select Units on Order. Next, let's go to the Axes. And on the Primary Y-axis and on the Primary X-axis, we'll remove the names so there's more space. Let's introduce an additional pane to see them one on top of the other, rather than side by side. Go to the Diagram section, go to Elements, and add a new pane. We have another available chart that will directly compare these two items. In order to move the On Order items down, we'll go to Series Views, we'll choose On Order, and let's move it to the new pane. Next, I'll go to the point labels for each of these items and remove them. In the case of the On Order, I'm going to select what we're going to show. In this case, instead of showing the values, I'll show the arguments. Next, go to Overlapping and select Default so that items don't overlap. And now go to Legend and remove it. Finally, we'll add a chart title and move it to the right. In keeping with our style, we'll go to Sego UI as our font. Okay, let's hit finish. Now as we go to preview, you'll see we're looking at items on order versus the items in stock. But it seems there are certain items in stock that aren't being sold, and those that are being sold look like their stock is low. You can see this is repeated for each category. Okay. Now I'll show you how to add a sparkline. So it would be nice to see a sparkline showing how many items were ordered per each order. Let's add some data from the Northwind dataset. We'll go to the Server Explorer and we'll drag order details on. Order details is a sub-item of products. In other words, there's an order for each product that's represented inside of these order details. Also, a quantity is displayed. Now I'll show a spark line that shows the quantity being ordered for the product over the lifetime of that product. To do that, let's go over to the detail section. We'll get a little more space, and from the toolbox, we'll drag a spark line control onto the design surface. Next, we'll bind it. Choose the Northwind dataset as its data source, and as the data member, we're going to drill down to categories. And notice we're in category products, but we want to select the product orders because that's going to have a number of values for each product. So let's select that. Next, we need to create a table adapter for it. We'll drop down and select the Order Details Table Adapter. And finally, as a value member, we'll select Quantity. Next, let's change the View Type to Area, and then let's change the color. Go to the View section, and in the Color area, we'll choose a bluish color that's not too loud. In this case, we'll choose Steel Blue. Finally, recall previously when we looked at this report, there was an odd and an even style. We want this spark line to obey the odd style as well. To do that, we'll go to the spark line itself, we'll scroll down to Styles, and under Odd Style, we'll select the off style we generated for the other elements. And that's it. We've effectively created a chart to show in stock versus on order for every product in a series of categories. Then we added a child table to the products table and created a spark line showing how many of these items were ordered per each order. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.